Hey guys, I'm Kel and I'm talking to you today about KFR, a black metal solo project hailing from France. Maxime Takati is the mastermind behind this bleak experience, and the album I'm talking to you about today is set to torment us on the 30th of June and will be KFR's ninth release. The album is Nihilist. If you're familiar with Maxime's work, in particular his work with the KFR project, you'd no doubt agree with me that KFR conjures up the most darkest and evil emotions from the depths of obscurity and the farthest corners of the opaque psyche. His music is renowned for being punishing, intrusively intense, and very twisted. I'm just gonna bat on for a little bit here, but it has to be said that after listening to Nihilist and being familiar with KFR's previous work, I have to say that this is Maxime's best work so far with this particular project. The production has improved so much, providing a density that has to be experienced for oneself. And the overall increase of heavy weight to his sound was certainly noticeable, with the introduction also of some very dark, enticing emotive melodies. Nihilist just felt like a complete package, sounding imposing, organized noise, second wave influences, and is often tormenting and confronting, just as I'm sure Maxime would have intended it to be. Maxime is also an incredible blood artist, and it needs to be said that his songs are a direct translation of his visual art. Just a bit of a fun fact there. Laden with apathetic and rhythmic beats, signature droning guitars transcending insanity and torment, and a vocal fold that just scratches and scathes across the soundscapes and gnaws at your skin as the listener. This is murky and eerie in its ambience, and I'm talking about the track Lord of the Flies. This for me was a journey of madness, you know, one that both was stomach twisting at times and completely enjoyable in a manic sense all at once. This track runs just over 7 minutes and is creepy and haunting in its entirety. And you know, it really has to be listened in solitude and in the dark for the most impact. The track Insect Boy hits me, and it's lifting the intensity, speed, and atmosphere, throwing a more traditional black metal composition, yet it's still stained with Maxime's distinct touches of off-centered guitar work, pitch black, disorientating induced production, and a mashup of tempo and rhythms. An incredible track, definitely one of my picks off this album. Maxime's style of obscure singing through this track is just so obtruse and sprinkled with a real sense of anguish. The insertion of heavy metal guitar notes offers such dark melodicism, and it just captured my attention fully. The traditional sound of 90s black metal is so thick throughout this latest offering and is stronger in some tracks such as I See You, with intense blasts, riffs that kicked me hard in the face, and a bleak cloud of unsettling vocals. While other tracks are more haunting in their ambience, with Maxime sounding like he's just climbed out of the pits of hell to take your soul. And I heard this probably in one of the most twisted tracks off this album, Master Mia, Ruler of Lave. Right, let's wrap this up, because I could talk about this artist for a very long time, but Nihilist gives you 9 tracks, with each track being completely void of light and very diverse as it transports you through its own journey, suffering with inner struggle, describing sickness, and is very occult driven. This is a wall of black noisescapes, traditional black metal sounds, and of course KFR's unique take on this subgenre, and he just keeps getting better in my opinion. You are in for a very unique experience as always, but for me particularly with this latest album. Go check it out, Nihilist. It is available 30th of June on Bandcamp. There's some teaser tracks up there now for you to enjoy. And please support KFR and Maxime on Facebook and on Instagram. To Maxime, you're amazing. Love this latest album. Thank you for the pre-listen. And this has been my Black Metal Reviews. I'm Kelly Pugh.